garden, a chariot of silver and gold. Gave the children all tickets, and a story he told of a time in the future that was sunshine and flowers. And the children grew sleepy in the sky's white towers. They dreamed of the story that the God had displayed. They saw all the wonders, tiny minds were amazed. They saw candy forests and dragons that breathed fire, but all that was evil in the misty mile. For the people and the lemonade, the people lived down by the sea, and each day the seagulls would wake them as they passed on their way. The people were kindly, they would sing to the sky, and each bright new morning the sun shone from their eyes. The children passed over, and all the people could see as they dived from the sky to the treacle sea. They bathed on the white sand, minutes turned into hours, and the children all giggled and gave each other flowers. The king from his castle came down to the sea, and he spoke to the children so patiently. He gave them small presents and bid them farewell, and the children unwrapped their tiny silver bells. Their tinkling floated across the island with ease, and it came back toward them on the perfume breeze. They smiled at the tinkling, they gazed at the sun, and they smiled at each other, pretty little ones. A beautiful white horse came down to the sea, and the children all climbed up as he knelt on one knee. They rode through the valleys and high over hills, and they laughed oh so loudly, their fear to kill. They came to a lakeside of deep velvet and green, and they all stared in wonder at its beauty serene. They climbed from the white horse, they watch as it goes, as they stood by the green lake water, kiss their toes. A boat in the distance was suddenly there, waiting to take the children to anywhere. The porcupine captain said that he didn't mind, in his coat of blunt needles he looked very kind. Children all stroked them and lost all their fears. They sailed through the sunshine across the green lake, and they drank lemonade and they ate ice cream cake. They landed in a dark cave as their boat disappeared, and they all stood in darkness, through the shadows they peered. But out of the blackness shone diamonds so bright, many tiny white hands shielded eyes from the light. It a pool of quicksilver stood Neptune so wise. New pearls were his white teeth, bright diamonds his eyes. He told of Sky Island and Poppy's magic cave and magic pink seashells to the children he gave. They listened intently as the music came forth from the magic pink seashells, and nobody talked. But Neptune had vanished when they lifted their eyes. From the cave, as two kingfishers cried in the bright, shiny sunlight, they got down on one knee. They listened to the seashells of the musical sea. The children said they would, and away they did fly through the white clouds of no time till forever it seems. And the children stayed children, and they lived in their dreams.